Draw one by Toronto. Here's Boyle trying to center. It goes to Kapanen. Kapanen curls in the corner. Kapanen back to the blue line to Carrick. The shot coming and it's wide. Rebound far side. Boyle couldn't get to it. Martin does. Martin swinging it back for Boyle. Boyle back to the goal. A shot. Scores! Scores! Are you kidding me? Kapanen slaps it home. What a brilliant pass from Brian Boyle. And the Leafs win it in overtime.
They scored a huge goal in the second period. And they get the big one in overtime. Kasperi Kapanen, this is not, isn't his biggest goal. Big one against Pittsburgh in game 81 to clinch. Big goal in the second period to tie it after the Capitals had taken a 2-1 lead on power play goals. And Mike Babcock puts his fourth line out of the offensive zone. And they come through again as Boyle starts to take it behind the net. Holtby follows him. Starts to go to his left. And again, Martin's going to get an assist on this as well. But Boyle going one way. Holtby goes with them, looking over his left shoulder. And Boyle funnels the pack in a cute little backhand pass back out to the other side. And Kapanen, like he did on Marc-Andre Fleury in the third period, has an empty net to snap it into. And the Leafs, not only back-to-back overtime games, but they come home with a very improbable split.
I'm numb. I'm absolutely numb.
You know, this may not be a bless you boy game yet, but you lose Roman Polak. You go through the two power play goals against. The fourth line comes through. So many things in this game. And to be down a defenseman for this long and into overtime, Morgan Rielly, Martin Marinson, Jake Gardner, Hunwick. I mean, this group, Connor Carrick, you've got to give them a lot of credit. There wasn't any panic. It was increased ice time. And they came through. Freddie Anderson was steady, if not spectacular, the rest of the way. And no matter what, those that might have called a sweep, you're wrong. And we'll see what else the Leafs can do to prove some of the experts wrong as they go home for Game 3 Monday night at the Air Canada Center.
Kasperi Kapanen from Boyle and Martin at 11:53 of the second overtime period. And the Toronto Maple Leafs are coming home, even in this series, at a game apiece for Game 3, which will be played on Monday night, right here on Sportsnet 590, The Fan, and the Leaf Radio Network. Miraculous
Let me ask you this. What is the biggest goal Kasperi Kapanen has scored in his career? He's got three, two in the playoffs, one in the game-clinching game in Game 81 against the Pittsburgh Penguins that got the Leafs in. That tied the game before Connor Brown won it. And, I mean, so many things have to go right to have success in the postseason. Your fourth line has to be great, shutting the other guys down.
Kind of ironic that it was their fourth line that wins game one on the goal by Wilson, and it's the Leafs' fourth line that pulls this one out of the fire in the second overtime.
It's going to make it a lot more fun coming home now, isn't it? So we've got the Canadian teams, although Calgary's still trying to even that series in Anaheim, but for Canadian teams, lose the first one, find a way to win the second one in exciting style, and the Leafs have kept up their end of the bargain.
Gord Stellick, Todd Lushko, Matt Brown, lots to talk about here as the Leafs win it in overtime, 4-3 on Kasperi Kapanen's second goal of the hockey game. We'll send it off to them and hope that you'll join us for Game 3 Monday night, shortly after 7 p.m. from the Air Canada Centre. You've been listening to Molson Canadian Leafs Hockey on Sportsnet 590 The Fan and the Maple Leafs Radio Network.